There has been a significant rise in the number of hospital admissions of people with eating disorders in England.
Nearly 30,000 people were hospitalised for conditions including anorexia and bulimia last year, around 40% more than the year before the pandemic.
Now, today, the eating disorder charity, SEED, will open two new therapy rooms in Hull, one named after the Big Brother star, Nikki Grahame, and another after 17-year-old Chelsea Blue. Both died 2 years ago. Jane McCubbin has taken a look around.
I asked the nurse on the phone, is she still going to be there when I get back? And it went quiet for a second. And she said, I don't think so.
I want her back, you know? I want to be able to, like, talk to her and... Sorry. Cuddle her.
Eating disorders destroy lives, families, friends.
For me, this was Nikki at her best. And
Nikki Grahame died when she was 38.
This is the Chelsea that we remember, a cheeky little smile.
Chelsea Blue was just 17.
Beautiful girl.
They lived worlds apart.
She always liked to cuddle into you.
But they died within 3 days of each other.
We were in another bar here, sipping on some drink in Paris.
And now, their names will be used to try and save the lives of others.
Bless her. It's just me, myself and I. Solo ride until I die, 'cause I got me for life. It was shocking how fast it happened. Seeing someone full of life with colour to suddenly go to a shell and someone that we didn't know.
Chelsea Blue's family say they fought for help to keep her safe at home, but in the end she spent 2 years in and out of hospital. In the last, she took her own life.
When I got to the hospital, it took me a long time to walk in them doors. I just couldn't go in. I just didn't want it to be real.
You had fought for help.
For a long time.
I'll show you this one. Out tonight with my beautiful best friend. We haven't had a night out for ages and we are literally catting around. I've known Nikki since I was 11 years old. We met when we were both in hospital. We were both suffering with an eating disorder. We used to run riot in there.
Look who I found.
When Nikki's anorexia deteriorated in lockdown, Carly set up a GoFundMe page to try and get help before finally Nikki was admitted to an NHS hospital.
One day she actually said, "Cos, you know, I think I'm dying." And I said to her, "Come on, Nix. You know, you can do this. Like, let's just get you to the hospital." So we did this GoFundMe because honestly, it was the last resort. I was coming back from work and she'd actually come back from the hospital that day. I just said, "Look, I'll see you on Saturday," which was going to be my weekend off. And we just said, "Love you."
Nikki died on the day they were due to meet.
Hi, oh,
don't come. Sorry.
Today, almost 2 years after Nikki and Chelsea Blue died, a new eating disorder drop-in centre is being opened by the charity SEED. Inside are therapy rooms dedicated to their two short lives.
Oh.
Do you think she'd like
it?
Oh,
wow.
Can I have a look?
Yeah.
When I first had contact with Steve, it is a phone call that I will never forget. And it was a father who was desperate to save his daughter's life. And I know how that feels because my dad fought long and hard with my mum to save mine.
I just wish that she come, we could get her off, you know, to come and get the help, but we know she's at peace. And
it's Chelsea's legacy living on. My eating disorder developed at around the age of 9. My mum and dad set up SEED 22 years ago, and I genuinely believe that through doing that, they helped bring me back and saved my life too. And the idea of the Chelsea Blue Therapy Room and the Nikki Grahame Therapy Room was just to give comfort and hope, and that they're going to be helping so many other people. So, the Chelsea Blue Room. And this is the Nikki Grahame Room.
Services like this are in short supply, facing increasing demand.
Jeez, oh my God, it's like she's designed this.
Go and have a look.
Since before the pandemic, adult hospital admissions for an eating disorder are up almost 40%. For children, it's just over 80%.
Overwhelmed.
The government told us these are tragic cases, highlighting the importance of our work to improve services. We're investing almost £1 billion in adult mental health care and £54 million a year in children's community eating disorder services.
And I feel like this is giving me a bit of hope, seeing this. And I wish there was more of this.
Yeah. The impetus really needs to be around early intervention. People are having to get to crisis point, to death's door, to be able to access treatment.
We love to help.
Very pleased to say the actor and chief executive of eating disorder charity Seed, Gemma, is with us now. And Carly, best friend of Nikki Grahame, you saw in the piece there as well. It was a big hug.
We've done a lot of that over the last 2 days, haven't we? Yeah. A lot of hugging, a lot of crying. It's quite an emotional. We've not seen that before either, so.
Yeah, well, it's obvious, and you were watching that with us here. The emotions are raw, aren't they? But I'm thinking, first of all, Gemma, you must be very proud. That exists now. There'll be people who are watching this who will benefit from that place that needn't have been there had you not done that.
I think for me, with it being in my hometown of Hull, you know, Princess Quay, that's where I grew up. And I remember walking through Princess Quay as a young girl who was struggling with an eating disorder and feeling lost. And if I'd have seen something like that, I do genuinely believe my life could have been very different. And I wouldn't change it because this is what has come from the hard stuff. But I just hope that this is the first step towards helping more people get the support they desperately deserve.
What happens in those rooms?
Well,
because that's what I think, what I'm interested in. When you say, you know, I would have gone in and asked for help or if I'd seen something, but then those rooms are there as well.
Yeah.
What happens in those? How do they help?
So we're starting to deliver a one-to-one therapy model with trained psychotherapists who give their time for free as part of their training. So we are able to give free therapy to people who are struggling with eating disorders. As well as that, we have set hours where we have a support and listening service. So anybody can come in who's just struggling and needs some help or direction as to where to go next. And we've also got the Marge's Den, which is after my mum and dad, which is the workshop room where we do emotional eating workshops. You know, because it's not just about anorexia, is it, Carly? It's binge eating disorder, it's bulimia. It affects everybody, and more awareness and understanding needs to be done. And, I think when you came, Carly, you were like, I've never seen anything like this, and I don't think I have either. No.
What did you think, Carly, in terms of how it would help?
I was absolutely speechless. I think, considering I work, you know, on the front line myself every day, and I see so many people struggling with this illness, to go in and see something like what Gemma and Seed have made was just... I had no words. But I haven't seen anything like this before. So for me, I was like, is this even happening? Has this actually been made? Has Gemma actually done this? Is this real? Is this going to happen? I was blown away.
In your experience, because obviously you were very, very good friends with Nikki. You call her your soulmate.
I do.
And do you, you know, Gemma says, you know, if it was in her position when she was struggling, she would have gone in. Do you think Nikki would have, that would have helped someone like Nikki?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I think that's what we struggle with, myself and Nikki's family, you know, and friends, that, you know, we were trying to find with Nikki help. And it was just so difficult, especially being an adult. You know, it's almost like you turn 18, where's the help? It's like there was nothing. It was like we was just, every day I'd come home from work and we'd be sort of ringing around, and it was just, we were just constantly hitting a brick wall. And it was so frightening to think, gosh, you know, if if we can't do this, what's everyone else out there? They must be petrified and struggling.
Gemma, you often hear, and we saw Steve, wasn't it, in the piece there. I mean, I can't imagine what it's like for him. Sort of seeing a place that could have helped, maybe, but often families and friends are terrified, they're bewildered by when something is happening to their friend, their daughter, their son, whoever this is happening to. That sense of not understanding is so hard to cope with.
We get so many people who, I mean, Seed was co-founded initially to help just the loved ones and families and caregivers, because my parents were just lost. There was nothing. And I think this is where we need to... We want to celebrate Nikki and Chelsea's lives, but we want to create change, and we can't do that without better government backing and funding to support eating disorder services. And early intervention is so key. Instead of blaming social media and society, we need to look at the bigger picture of getting that help and support in crisis when they need it most.
The government does say it's investing £1 billion, £1 billion in community mental health care. I've got to say it because, it's the Department of Social Health and Social Care. £1 billion in community mental health care for adults with severe mental illness, including eating disorders, by 2024. An additional £54 million a year for children and young people's community eating disorder services to increase capacity of community eating disorder teams across the country. Both of you, I mean, you rolled your eyes, you flung your hands in the air because you're through frustration. Mm. Why is there that frustration? The money's kind of being put out there. Is it because it's not...
I don't know where it filters down to, Margaret. Okay. Like, how many times have...
We've spoken
so many times over the years, and it's like, when is it going to get to a point where change actually comes? You know, at Seed, and we've talked about this a lot, we deliver a whole person approach, a holistic approach. It's about kindness, it's about empathy, it's about listening, you know, and we've lived it, and that's what works, you know.
Can I ask you, there'll be people, and you'll know this because you've done plenty of broadcast interviews, there'll be a family watching this at home somewhere who are thinking, this is happening to us, this, and we don't know what to do. We're in that place where everyone's scared. What do you say? How do you start that process?
I mean, you know, I've had people reach out to me and say, you know, knowing that I've kind of worked in this and every day, and say, you know, do you know of anywhere? And first of all, I would just give them my advice and things like, you know, what they can do. But I'd say you need to go to your doctor first, but that's even difficult. And when you go to your doctor, you know, they offer you medication and stuff, but where's the actual help after that? You know, I'm a bit speechless on that one because...
And even, okay, I understand it completely, but even before you get to that point, that notion of keeping things secret, which is so often the case, isn't it? You're not talking to anyone.
I think, look at us. There's no stigma. We've been there, we've lived it, and it was hell on earth for us, but we got through it because we started to use our voice and we started speaking and looking at the underlying issues. And I think if anybody out there is struggling, yes, we've talked about how difficult it is for services, but recovery is possible. And we're not perfect, are we? Like, yeah. We're talking last night, we're like, oh, don't yeah. worry. But there is hope, but we need to deliver this message with a stronger voice, and we need more people backing us to help those people so they don't feel desperately alone. But for me, the Resource Centre in Princess Quay is a statement of going, we are here, we are seeing you, and we are hearing you, and you have nothing to be ashamed of. So please, reach out to help. Reach out for help.
Really appreciate both of you being here this morning, your honesty and what you're doing. Gemma, Carly, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
If you have been affected by any of the issues raised in that conversation, you can find organisations which offer help and support on the BBC Action Line website. You can just search for bbc.co.uk/actionline.
And a little bit of a mutual tap on the legs there.
I think Nikki brought us together.
Definitely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.